everyone. Welcome to Stillwater High School. George Plummer here on 106.1 The Ranch. It's the Class 4A Area Tournament, and the Chickasha Fight the Chicks preparing to take on the Seminole Chieftains in an elimination game. Chicks to take on the unranked Seminole Chieftains. A team, though, kind of like Elgin, flying under the radar, a 20-win campaign for the Chieftains. We're going to take an opening timeout. We'll be back with more pregame in a moment. This is high school basketball on 106.1 The Ranch.
Wait, copay remains the same. Liberty Drug, downtown Chickasha, where coffee's still a nickel and the conversation is always free. Go Fightin' Chicks from Liberty Drug.
Call 224-1204.
If you are interested in how you can save thousands of dollars.
State University, he played basketball at Guymon. He also teaches math. But for Seminole, finals 65-49. But then in the regional finals last Saturday night, they lost to a very good Tulsa. 6 points, 10 rebounds, 5 blocks per game for that big man. So we'll definitely be looking out for him. And the Chickasha Fighting Chicks should be at full strength this afternoon with the three seniors. 6'1 senior Brock Henderson, 6'2 senior MacGyver Bowles, 5'10 senior Caleb Crowder, 6' junior Ethan Christian, and 6'3 junior Caleb Ross. And we'll see if Logan Johnson, who did make the trip, is going to get the start. And Logan does get the start, a 6'8. He's going to jump against Logan Johnson, and the game is underway. And Caleb Crowder runs down the ball in the deep near corner. The Chicks are going from our left to right as we get things started. And Seminole is going to start out in a man-to-man defense as Brock Henderson will run the offense at the point. Screen set, MacGyver Bowles. They get it into Bowles as Brock was double-teamed. And then Seminole gets a takeaway in Chickasha possession. Looks like the Chicks are going to go man-to-man on their defense here as Kason Clark will run the show out near the center circle, covered by Caleb Crowder. And the big 6'8 junior working the left low blocks. The ball goes to the right baseline to the right elbow extended. That's Nance. Dumps it off to Stevens on the baseline. And in the lane, and layup will not go. Rebound loose, picked up by Logan Johnson. So the Chicks will have the ball scoreless in the opening moments here of the ball game. Johnson near side wing out to Henderson. To the deep near corner, Ethan Critchett catch and shoot. Triple spins out. Rebound tipped out by Henderson into the hands of MacGyver Bowles. So the Chicks reset, and Ethan Christian's going to drive in. It looks like in the right low blocks. Henderson, wraparound pass into MacGyver Bowles, and he's fouled driving into the basket. Seminole left the lane wide open for MacGyver Bowles to get two opportunities from the foul line here as Kason Clark is called for the foul. And MacGyver's been shooting free throws very well. On the board with that first foul shot there. And the second free throw is good. So in the first couple of minutes of play, now the Chicks are going to go to zone press here against Seminole as they work the ball quickly or slowly up court. Three man in the back, get it into the front court to the big man Nance. And now they go to the half court game. Driving right side is Cotner. Floater off the glass. Henderson going one-on-one on the other end. His layup won't go. Rebound down to Shamario Stevens. Here come the Chieftains in transition. A pull-up three, no good. Nance with the rebound. Can't get the putback, but Nance would go to the line for the big man at the line for the foul shot. Of course, Chickasha coached by, assisted by Link Deering and Bobby Sanford. Nance at the foul line and gets one of two. At 3-2. Just 2 minutes into the ball game, and Henderson walks it across the 10-second line on the perimeter with MacGyver Ball setting up at the high post. Henderson works left side, drives in, and gets the layup. There's Henderson's first basket. They make it a 5-3, make it a 4-3 game. Chieftains working methodically up court against that zone press. Here comes Stevens. And his pass is deflected by the Chicks, but Seminole gets it to the right elbow. Now there's a step back by Stevenson that goes. Shamar will give the Chieftains back the lead at 5-4. MacGyver Bowles works the baseline. The ball is on the left sideline to MacGyver Bowles out front. Crossover dribble, gives it up to Henderson. Working against Nance. Give and go, lob pass out to Caleb Crowder, over to Ethan Christian, deep far corner, Logan Johnson drives baseline, his first opportunity, can't get the layup. Coverage of CHS basketball, a presentation of Chickasha Lumber Company, Sony Drive-In, and those businesses and individuals sponsoring our games, and thank them for letting you be at home or wherever you might be. Johnson, and Seminole gets the rebound, so Seminole hangs on to a 5-4 lead. Quickly up court to get the ball in the hands of Nance. And his wrap caught her to inbound. Over to Phelan Wolf on the give and go to Stevens. Far side against Ethan Christian. Spin move and a traveling violation will be called on her first turnover. So a defensive matchup here in the early going. MacGyver Bowles near side wing, out to Henderson, over to Johnson, left elbow extended, reversing the pass, entry pass to Brock Henderson from MacGyver Bowles. And Henderson scores to give the Chicks back the lead, give MacGyver Bowles the assist, and Henderson to the line, check out of the ball game, and 5'10 sophomore Dayton Jackson checks in. He's averaging 6.7 rebounds a ball game. Henderson missed the free throw, rebound. So the Chicks not shooting free throws very well here. 2 of 5 in the early going, but up 6-5. Seminole breaks the 2-2-1. Wraparound pass to the far side. Jackson drives baseline. Head fake on MacGyver Bowles. Can't get it. Gets his own rebound. And scores on the putback. Jackson gives Seminole back the lead. Henderson, baseline jumper. Can't get the roll. And the rebound by Will Cotner. The Chicks get a takeaway. I think Brock got a takeaway. Brock. Where Brock's going to be called, let's see. It's going to be, so Brock Henderson with the steal and a second turnover for Seminole. Deep far corner, Caleb Crowder for the triple on the inbounds pass. And Caleb Crowder gives the Chicks a 9 lead. Already 6 lead changes here in this first half, first quarter. Driving into transition basket, no, rebound. And Ethan Christian has it, and he is knocked down from behind. But Ethan's okay. We've got a sub in as David Thibodeau-Benoit checks in the contest for Logan Johnson. Chicks up 9-7, 3:39 to go, opening quarter of play. On the perimeter, Thibodeau-Benoit, Caleb Christian is, they are really playing Brock Henderson close. This could be a box and one here against the Chicks. Thibodeau, Benoit to the near side, Caleb Crowder for the triple. This side is too hard off the iron. Rebound, tipped out of there by Ethan Christian, and the Chicks get a reset. Good work there by Ethan to get that board. And Henderson will direct it offense out near half court. Dribble drive, diagonal pass to Christian. And his pass is deflected. There's a takeaway. And Seminole will slow it down. 3 minutes to go in the quarter. Chicks up by 2. Top of the key is Will Cotner. Drives to the right side. Dishes off to the far side wing, Dayton Jackson. Skip pass to the near side. Almost hit Coach Pulliam in the head. Behind the back pass. And driving in. Good defense by the Chicks. A no shot. And we're going to have a foul, I think, on not allowing a shot in the lane. So Seminole to inbound behind the left low blocks. Lob pass out front. And they'll set it up front with Adam Nance, the big 6'8 sophomore. 9-7 Chickasha. Top of the key, a quick catch and shoot. 3 is off the iron. Rebound, MacGyver Bowles cleans the glass. So the Chicks get a stop quickly up court. Henderson near side wing. Checking out the defense, drives baseline, kicks it out to Caleb Crowder. Another triple on the way, going to be short. Rebound into the hands of Adam. So the Chicks one and done on that possession. Seminole has it, trailing by 2. Up 3, a catch and shoot 3 is off the mark. And MacGyver Bowles, his second consecutive defensive rebound. On the run out, here comes Brock Henderson, tripped up. Falls on the floor, maintains his dribble. A held ball will be called. Then Christian, and with under 2 minutes to go in the quarter, Chickasha with the ball, or Seminole with the ball, Chickasha with the lead, and again, the Chicks with that kind of an extended zone press. Seminole gets the ball into the front court now with the big man, Adam Nance, being defended by Brock Henderson. Dribble drive, and the lay-in won't go. Rebound. by Brock Henderson. The Chicks have the numbers. Brock Henderson leads Caleb Crowder up court and off the glass. No good. Gets his own rebound, or Caleb Ross, rather, and a foul on Ross on the rebound. Caleb Ross with his first, and with a minute 34 to go, Chieftains have the ball. Chicks have the two-point lead. Baseline, there's a steal by MacGyver Bowles up to Brock Henderson. Boy, MacGyver's had a great first quarter already defensively. Chicks had the ball with a two-point lead. And Henderson between the rings, sneaking his way up to the top of the key, diagonal pass to Caleb Ross, deep far quarter. Now he's going to spot up for the long deuce. Skips across the rim. Rebounds. And the Chieftains have another chance to tie here as we are now under a minute to go in the opening quarter. Near side wing, Jackson, deep near corner, back to Jackson, and fouled by Caleb Ross. Fouls already on Seminole, and Jackson snaps game for Kaysen Clark. Second free throw, no good. Chicks maintain the rebound. Logan Johnson's going to control the board, and Adam Nance, the 6'8 junior, is called for his second foul. Then Milam Heating and Air Conditioning, and our best bank. Logan Johnson worked his way into the starting lineup late in the season, and Johnson drops in the foul shot. His first point here of this area tournament. The Chicks have to win three in a row if they hope to get to the state tournament. That's going to be a tall task as Johnson missed the second free. Comes down to Kaysen Clark, and the Chicks have a three-point lead. Make that a two-point lead at 10-8 with 40 seconds to go in the quarter. Chieftains work the perimeter, setting a high screen. Now top of the key is Jackson. Over to Will Cochner. Far sideline now, working the weave out front. Chicks in man-to-man. Left elbow extended. They get it into Nance. Drives in against MacGyver Bowles. Missed the shot. Rebound slapped out of there by MacGyver Bowles. Chicks with a two-point lead. Will Cochner to inbound for the deep near corner. Looks inside. Comes out to the wing. And out to the top of the key with 13 seconds to go. That is Colel Harris. They go deep far corner. Counterclockwise, top of the key. 5 seconds to go. Drives left elbow, spins, dumps it off to Nance. The 15-footer, too strong. MacGyver Bowles the rebound. That's the end of the first quarter. Chickasha 10, Seminole 8. And you are listening to the Class 4A Area Tournament on 106.1 The Ranch. The Chickasha Fighting Chicks taking on the Seminole Chieftains. And they include Small Engine Service, the Millett Hunter Insurance Agency, as well as Ross Healthcare. They are all helping us out with our coverage here from Stillwater High School. A beautiful day. And again, the winner will go on to play tomorrow afternoon to get things started. 10-8, Chicks with the lead. And again, 6 lead changes in that first quarter of play. Just 1 tie, and that was at 2. Brock Henderson trying to get open as the ball is on the perimeter with Logan Johnson and Caleb Crowder. Henderson has it near sideline. Entry pass to Thibodeau Benoit. Back to Henderson, and Henderson reverse layup. Chicks are only 3 of 7 from the foul line in the first quarter. Brock Henderson with 4 points. Caleb Crowder with 3. Free throw would not go. Gets the rebound. So Brock Henderson 0 of 2 from the foul line. The Chicks are 3 of 8. 10-8, Chickasha with the lead. Chieftains going from our right to left. Seminoles, one of their best players, Shamario Stevens, their leading scorer, out of the ball game after picking up 2 quick fouls. So Seminole in the half-court game, working the three-man weave on the perimeter. Jackson drives in, and some contact, and Logan Johnson's going to be called for a... So the teams match up a little bit better now. Chiefs is to inbound, out to the top of the key to Phelan Wolf, and he'll give it up to Shamario Stevens. Only 2 points for him. Going against Logan Johnson, drives right side, and gets the basket at 10. A minute into this second quarter of play, teams seem to be matched up pretty well, very evenly, even talent. Entry pass to MacGyver Bowles from Brock Henderson. Bowles missed the shot, but he gets his own rebound and the putback. Way to stay with it for MacGyver in the at 12-10. That's 4 rebounds for Bowles. Now the Chieftains on the three-man weave on their end of the court. Chicks in man-to-man defense. Phelan Wolf playing catch with Shamario Stevens. Crossover dribble. Back out top, driving the left side of the lane. A step back triple is good. ball handling skills and a step back triple, and we have our seventh lead change as Seminole takes a 13-12 lead. Henderson, entry pass there to MacGyver Bowl, spins right, spins left, can't get the shot. Rebound is going to be controlled by the Chieftains, it looks like there. So it looks like that's going to be a turnover on the Chicks. I have four on CHS, three on the Chieftains. Driving in is Shamario, can't get it. Thibodeau Bedwall with the rebound for CHS. Quickly up court to Henderson. Far side wing, has to slow it down. And gives it up to Caleb Crowder. And back to Henderson, is going to be shadowed by Khalil Harris. Henderson at the center circle with a left-hand dribble. A 1-4 offensive look for the Chicks. Crossover dribble, entry pass to MacGyver Bowles, wide open, some contact. The basket is good, and MacGyver Bowles going to the foul line. And the foul is on Dayton Jackson. That is his third. Well, they just say one. That's right. I put my hash marker in the wrong. MacGyver Bowles gets the old-fashioned three, and the Chicks regain a two-point lead at 15-13. Chieftain spread the floor defensively. They kick the ball to the deep near corner. Three-pointer on the way, and that's an open three. We have our ninth lead change. Seminole 16, Chickasha 15. At about the five-minute mark here in the second quarter. Henderson over by the far sideline at half court. Takes it to the top of the key. To the right elbow, dumps it off to Caleb Crowder for the triple. Off the left iron, rebound. Oh, the tip-in by MacGyver Bowles wouldn't go. And set the board and a chance to extend their lead. Shamario Stevens drive, spins, skip pass, and good ball movement on the perimeter by the Chieftains. And Khalil Harris going to be called for traveling. MacGyver Bowles leads the Chicks in scoring with seven. Brock Henderson with four. Caleb Crowder three. Logan Johnson one. That's it for scoring for the Chicks. Brock Henderson spin move with the right elbow, drives in, trudging it up and off to Thibodeau Benoit. I don't know if David is back in the ball game. He's in for Khalil Harris with 4:25 to go in the quarter, and it's a 16-15 lead for Seminole. Will Cotner working against Thibodeau Benoit out near the half-court line. Near side wing, that's Shamario Stevens driving baseline against MacGyver Bowles. And a triple on the way, off the mark, rebound. The Chieftains, they dump it off of the baseline, mid-range jumper there. And the Chieftains take a three-point lead. Henderson on the other end splits a double-team, lost a handle on it, picked up by MacGyver Bowles, turns and shoots, he gets the basket. 7.25 for MacGyver Bowles. Chicks within one at 18-17. Chicks have been in man-to-man defense the entire game. There's a triple, another triple. Somebody's going to have to get on him. That's three triples for Seminole here in this second quarter, and they now have a four-point lead at 21-17. Their largest lead. Logan Johnson, top of the key. Over to Thibodeau Benoit, out to Henderson. He wants the triple off the iron. Rebound tipped out by Thibodeau Benoit into the hands of Phelan Wolf down the far sideline. Doesn't have the number, so he'll slow it down, but look out! A three-pointer is rounded to seven in the first 5 minutes. And the Chicks will have the basketball. Coach P takes the timeout to try to settle the troops, but the Chicks have to start playing some perimeter defense to get these three-pointers away, and we've got a foul on the baseline against Seminole. And looked like Sorrell was leading Glencoe. Brock Henderson gets one of two, making a 24-18 ball game with 2:44 to go in the half. Elimination game. Shamario Stevens gets past MacGyver Bowles with six, and it's back to an eight-point lead, or up to an eight-point lead, 26-18. Henderson covered by Dayton Jackson. The freshman Austin Albright in the ballgame now for the Chicks. There's MacGyver Bowles, works the baseline, splits a double team, can't get the shot, gets his own rebound, the putback, yes, and a foul. MacGyver Bowles just so strong underneath. He's got 9 points in the quarter. A little better here in the second, 2 of 4. And MacGyver Bowles, free throw spins out. Dayton Jackson, I've got that as his third rebound. 26-20, Chieftains. It's a two-possession game with about 2:05 to go in the half. Top of the key now, working the perimeter game. Here is Khalil Harris back in the ball game. Near side wing. Around the horn they go. Shake and bake move, and MacGyver Bowles gets another steal, his second of the game. The Chicks had the numbers on the other end, but Austin Albright can't keep the ball from going out of bounds. Wasn't really a very good pass. And the Chieftains will take advantage. They've got the basketball back. 6-point lead for Valen Wolford against Logan Johnson out front. Now Shamario Stevens to the right wing. Spin move. Can't get the shot, but he's been in the bonus the entire second quarter, but only 2 points from the free throw line as the Chieftains really went on this big run. The Chieftains with 9 points. Stevens, their leading scorer, with 5 points. And still 5 points. He got one of two free throws. MacGyver Bowles the rebound. And the Chicks going to work quickly up court. Henderson splits traffic and makes the basket, but there's some contact and picking up his second foul. Brock's going to hit these free throws. Only 1 of 4, and now 1 of 5. And Brock is off the mark on the foul shots today. Had a little better follow through. Six, but the Chicks trail by 6 at 27-21 with about a minute 15 to go in the opening half. Shamario Stevens drives. Head fake, and he gets 7 points for him in the quarter. It's back to an 8-point lead for Seminole. Matches their biggest lead of the game. Brock Henderson, top of the key. Seminole in man-to-man defense. Entry pass to MacGyver Bowles. He's fouled as he goes to the hoop. And where he is 3 of 4, he leads Chickasha with 11 points and misses that foul. I think this is the worst foul shooting I've seen for Chickasha this season. Well under 50% for the game. That one much, but the Chicks are still trailing by 7 at 29-22 with under a minute to go in the second quarter. Chieftains work the perimeter. There's Jackson, and the pass deflected by Austin Albright. Chicks will let Henderson bring the ball across the 10-second line. Logan Johnson sets up at the high post. Henderson, entry pass to MacGyver Bowles, splits a double team, and that looked pretty easy right there. For MacGyver Bowles, makes it a 5-point game, 30 seconds to go. Top of the key, Stevens drives in, finger roll layup. So it's a 7-point game, and with 15 seconds to go, the Chicks will work for the final shot. Henderson at the center circle, 1-4 offensive look for the Chicks. 10 seconds, Henderson says, come on out, Logan, to the left elbow, sets the screen, drives right, kicks it out to Ethan Christian, out to Brock Henderson for the triple on mark, yes! Brock Henderson gets the triple off the assist from Ethan Christian. And we've got a 4-point game going to the locker room. Seminole 31, Chickasha 27. We're at halftime at Stillwater High School, and the Chickasha Fighting Chicks trailing Seminole 31-27 right now. Seminole with a big second quarter, outscoring the Chicks 23-17. They had an 8-point lead at one time, but a big triple by Brock Henderson just before halftime get the Chicks within 4 at 31-27.
That bring our community to life. So if you're looking for a bank that cares about the community as much as you do, there's only one bank, one local bank. First National Bank and Trust Company, 11 locations to serve you. Member FDIC.
Tired of fighting with bargain brand lawn equipment? And the Chicks, if they could get their 3-point game going, that would start the second half of play, going from our right to left. Brock Henderson, Ethan Christian, Caleb Crowder, Logan Johnson, MacGyver Bowles. And Henderson looks inside, comes the near side wing to Crowder. Slipped a little bit. Went a little moisture in front of the Chick bench over there. Zone defense here by Seminole as Henderson's slowing it down. Ethan Christian too, a double low post look with Johnson and Bowles. MacGyver Bowles gets the entry pass, missed the shot. It was deflected a little bit there by the big 6'8 junior Adam Nance. So he gets a rebound. There's an entry pass broken up by Caleb Crowder. The ball is loose, picked up by Crowder, off to Henderson. 2-on-2, Henderson driving in, dumps it off to Logan Johnson for the triple, deep far corner off the mark. Rebound chased down by Ethan Christian. The Chicks get another chance. That would have been a big triple had Logan been able to drop that in. However, it wouldn't go, but the Chicks get a second opportunity here. They'll slow it down. Brock Henderson working the high post. Chicks on the perimeter. MacGyver Bowles camped out. And now a three by Ethan Christian won't go. And MacGyver Bowles tipped. So Chicks could not get a basket and two tries there. Seminole with the four-point lead. Still looking for our first score of the game in the second half. Driving in with the left side. Shot wouldn't go. Ethan Christian, another rebound here in the opening moments, and leads Henderson up court against the double team, and he's going to be fouled by Brock. Really has to get these free throws to go in. Only two of those with 14 for CHS. And Henderson back within one possession now for CHS. Two quick dribbles for Brock. That free throw good. So the Chicks strike first in the second half, but they trail 31-29. Chicks still in man-to-man defense. Here's Shamario Stevens, Seminole's leading scorer with 11 points so far tonight. Tries to draw out the Chick defense a little bit. Right elbow, they kick it over to Stevens, drives in and lays it in. He's very quick. 13, and that gets the Chieftains back up by four. Henderson at the center circle. Phelan Wolf playing about three steps off. Pass goes to the far sideline. Around the horn to Brock Henderson. Drives left side, leans in and gets the lay in. Brock Henderson once again, 33-31. Blanchard and Newcastle girls come up tonight at 6:30 here at Stillwater. Driving in is Nance. King. Oh, he does get the layup. He got the roll. As Adam Nance, just his first field goal for the 6A junior. And Seminole back up by four, 35-31 as the teams trade baskets. Logan Johnson on the perimeter. Chicks, really, we've said that they don't like to play a half-court game necessarily, but they're getting forced into that here this afternoon. Christian drives in to Logan Johnson. Pass out into MacGyver Bowles, lost a handle on it, kicks it back out to Henderson. He steps back for the triple, swish. MacGyver Bowles, another assist. Chieftain still lead though, 35-34. Entry pass to Nance, double team. Spins, and we've got a hell ball. I didn't see who reached it. 4:44 to go in the third. Behind the left low block, Carter to the deep far corner. To the left elbow, that's Nance. Off to Stevens, top of the key from the left elbow. No, the tip in by Nance won't go, but Nance will get two from the foul line. And the Chicks down by one. And the big man with DeHart Heating and Air Conditioning, First National Bank and Trust, and the Millett Hunter Insurance Agency. Second free throw spins out, rebound, Caleb Crowder. The Chicks down by two at 36-34. MacGyver Bowles and Logan Johnson work the low blocks. Entry pass to Bowles. Drives baseline. Head fake. Strong to the hoop. Can't get it. Rebound. Henderson in the lane. Dumps it off to MacGyver Bowles. He lost it out of bounds. Had a chance there, but misfired just a little bit. And the Chieftains will push the ball up court. Here's Stevens on the baseline to the big man out to the far side wing. Back to Nance against MacGyver Bowles. And Skittles! From MacGyver Bowles, he takes the charge from Adam Nance, who picked up his fourth foul. Nance ducked his shoulder, ran right into MacGyver Bowles, and when you draw a charge from the opposing player, you get a bag of Skittles. So there's a turnover for Seminole. Now the Chicks, again, a second opportunity to tie the ball game as we pass the halfway point of this third quarter. Henderson to the far sideline. Screen set by Johnson. Pull-up jumper, right elbow. No. Rebound comes down to Dixon. So for the third trip down court, the Chicks unable to get back to a tie. Top of the key is Stevens. Going against Christian. Right elbow. Step back deuce is short. Rebound MacGyver Bowles. He leads Brock Henderson up court. Two on two. And Henderson, little reverse layup. Yes, and the foul. So Henderson ties the ball game at 36. And Dayton Jackson just picked up his third foul. And Brock Henderson with a chance to give the Chicks back the lead. And Seminole wants a timeout. 3:27 to go in the third. Chickasha 36 and Seminole 36. And we'll just keep it right here. Seminole has their big man, Adam Nance, with four fouls. Will Cotner with three. And Dayton Jackson just picked up his third. And Brock Henderson get the foul shot, so we are tied at 36. That's our third tie of the game. So the Chicks have fought back from an 8-point deficit. Right elbow is Kaysen Clark, top of the key. There's Shamario Stevens, spin move, kicks it out to the deep far corner. Betch Jackson drives against MacGyver Bowles. He gets the layup, and MacGyver Bowles at the line for the old-fashioned three, the 5'10 sophomore, averaging 6 points a ball game. And he's right now as the Chieftains regain a three-point lead at 39-36. Johnson sets a screen at the right elbow. Here's Henderson. Entry pass, not a very good one, taken away by Dayton Jackson on the run out. Gets past the defender, and he's going to throw it away. Jackson was pressured by Henderson. Elimination game. Henderson at the center circle. Setting up the offense here. 2-3 zone here for Seminole. Entry pass to MacGyver Bowles. Triple team, step back, won't go. Logan Johnson tips the rebound to himself. He's double teaming the baseline, attacks the basket, came loose, kicks it out to Henderson for the triple off the iron, and the rebound down to Seminole's Phelan Wolf. Still a three-point lead for the Chieftains, 2:14 to go in the third. And the Chieftains work the perimeter. There's Shamario Stevens against Ethan Christian on the near side wing. They go to the corner to Wolf, entry pass there to Stevens. Turn, shoots, and kick at the basket. Rebound. Fought for. Caleb Crowder comes out of the pack with it. Here come the Chicks in transition. Christian will slow it down to go in the quarter. Chicks trail by three. Ethan Christian at the center circle with a stationary dribble. Now Henderson will take over. Caleb Crowder far sideline out to Henderson. To Christian, left elbow extended. Reversing the pass over to Henderson. Entry pass to MacGyver Bowles, turn, shoot, scores. MacGyver Bowles with 16. 1 point game Chieftains lead. Near side wing, that's Wolf. Right elbow, no shot. On the wing, Stevens drives baseline. He's double teamed. Kicks it out to the wing, a three-pointer on the way. Off the mark, rebound. Ethan Christian with one, the third. Christian, the lob pass down to Logan Johnson. Deep far corner, takes the triple. Off the mark, and the rebound. The carry to the Chieftains, Will Cotner. Now a minute to go in the third, with Seminole leading 39-38. Stevens against Christian, splits a double team and gets the reverse layup. Steen, and it's a three-point lead once again for Seminole. Henderson now had a chance for the dribble penetration, but turns it down. Half-court game now. Looks like the possession arrow favors Chickasha. They'd like to score here. They're going to shoot for the final shot. A long three for Caleb Crowder. Holy cow! From 30, Caleb Crowder ties the ball game at 41. His second of the game for Caleb Crowder. And we are tied at 41 with 20 seconds to go. Shamario Stevens. We go baseline. A lot of pressure by Crowder. The right elbow. Stevens drives in. Gets the basket and the foul with 11.3 seconds to go. I believe his third trip to the foul line, one of two from the line so far. But we've got a dandy in Stillwater. Free throw is good. Chicks have plenty of time to score. Henderson picks up the ball with 11 seconds to go across the timeline. Double high post look for the Chicks. Henderson between the rings, takes it to the far sideline. Top of the key, wraparound pass into MacGyver Bowles. Shoots, can't get the basket, but two free throws for MacGyver. Fourth. And MacGyver Bowles, who was 4 of 6 from the line, gets the first. Chieftains will sub in Khalil Harris for the final 1.8. Make sure you play good defense. Seminole's pretty quick. Second free throw off the heel. They get the rebound. A baseball pass from 75 feet is wide right. It's the Chicks. And 18 points for Shamario Stevens leads Seminole. Chicks do have the ball to start the fourth quarter of play. They trail 44-42. Baseline pass to MacGyver Bowles. Ducks his shoulder, scores, and we are tied at 44. Driving in is Stevens in the deep far corner, working the weave, a long triple for Wolf is good. Second three-pointer of the game, and that gives Seminole back a three-point lead, 47-44. Great outside shooters. They have not missed many. From beyond the arc, the Chicks not shooting quite as well. There's a nice pass. Oh, my goodness, a nice entry pass to MacGyver Bowles. We'll go to the line for the two-shot foul. Logan just 1 of 4 from the foul line. Let's see if he shoots a little better here in the fourth, and he cannot. Third quarter, so a total of 10 of 20 two now for CHS. And Logan Johnson missed both. And Shamario Stevens gets the rebound. Still a three-point game. A minute gone here in the fourth. Chick still the man-to-man defense. Everybody on the perimeter here for the Chieftains. Now Stevens works against David Thibodeau Benoit, who checked in the ball game during the timeout. Still on the perimeter, there is Stevens. Skip pass to the deep near corner, three-pointer. That's deflected by MacGyver Bowles. Loose ball picked up by Henderson. We got a three-on-two. Henderson takes it all the way, gets past the defender, missed the layup. Rebound picked up by Seminole. They've got the numbers going the other way. Shamario Stevens and missed the basket. And here is Shamario Stevens at the line for the two-shot foul with a minute and a half gone here in this fourth quarter. And the free throw, 7 of 11. But the Chicks, less than 50% today from the line. And the Stevens gets after the Chicks tied it at 44. They'll set up far side of the court. Now a step back deuce, top of the key. Brock Henderson can't get it. Rebound down to, but you like Brock to shoot, but might have shot a little bit too quickly that time. Chieftain's biggest lead has been 8. That was in the second quarter. And they'll work the perimeter. They get to Dayton Jackson, deep far corner. Works against Caleb Ross, splits a double team. Gets the basket and one. Jackson, 2 of 3 from the line. Missed that one. Rebound by Ethan Christian. It's a 7-point lead as Seminole's on a 7-0 run. 2 minutes gone in the fourth. Caleb Crowder turns down a triple. Baseline pass to Caleb Ross. Drives in. Can't get the shot. Gets his own rebound. The putback, yes, for Caleb Ross, his first basket. After the Chick timeout, it's Seminole basketball with a 5-point lead. Left wing is Phelan Wolf. Entry pass to Stevens and scoring average. Back to a 7-point lead with 5:20 to go in regulation. Christian baseline to Caleb Ross. The skip pass over to Brock Henderson. Touch pass to Crowder. Near side, Ethan Christian for the triple. He's got to get hot. Can't get it. And block out. But MacGyver Bowles takes the rebound out of the hands of the defender. He gives it up to Brock Henderson. Gets the basket. So great alert play there by MacGyver Bowles to take the rebound out of the hands of Dayton Jackson. Chicks down by 5. Shamario Stevens works with the Dayton Jackson. A 20-win season for the Chieftains. Trying to extend it here. Step back 3. Won't go. Caleb Ross kicks the rebound away. We've got a traveling violation called on. Seminole will give the ball back to the Chicks, trailing by 5. Now the Chieftains are going to go zone. Henderson out front. Right corner is Ethan. Christian spots for the triple. Can't get it. Rebound by Seminole. Taken away by MacGyver Bowles again. But a behind-the-back pass, a no-look pass taken away by Shamario Stevens. Now the Chieftains set it up top of the key. This is Dayton Jackson against Ethan Christian. And Ethan Christian with a reach-in foul. Khalil Harris to inbound right in front of the Seminole student section. Entry pass as Caleb Ross came in and missed here in this second half. He is 3 of 4 from the foul line for the game and has 22 points to lead all scorers and gets the first. Back a 6-point lead. Chieftains still have a foul to give here in this fourth quarter. Second free throw, no. MacGyver Bowles with the rebound. I've got him for 8 rebounds. And the Chicks, now with under 4 minutes to go in the game, they trail by just 6. Around the horn they go. A long three for Brock. Henderson is off the mark. Doesn't even draw iron. And the Chicks can't get it. They can't get any shots. Can't get any rebounds. And now Seminole with a 6-point lead. And they'll milk the clock here. 3:35 to go. Stevens drives in. They let him go. No rebound by MacGyver Bowles. So the Chicks get a stop in transition. Henderson through the lane. Dumps it out to Caleb Crowder. He'll take a triple. Spins out. Caleb Ross, a big rebound. Gives it to Caleb Crowder. A couple of big NBA steps. Kick. Gets Seminole. Gets the rebound. Chicks have not scored the last 2 or 3 trips down court. But still within 6 at 54-48. And here's Shamario Stevens holding the ball out near the half court over to Dayton Jackson. And Seminole's going to, they're going to run the four corners here. They're going to make the, it's still a long ways away from this game being over. Three-pointer on the way, deep far corner, spins out. Caleb Ross and MacGyver Bowles fights for the rebound. A three-point line in that second quarter. We had three triples that gave Seminole their lead that they've really not given up. Chickasha's not led here in the second half. Henderson takes advantage of a screen. His pass to MacGyver Bowles. Back to David Thibodeau. And he can't get the basket. MacGyver Bowles gets his 10th rebound and the putback with 21. And the Chicks down 54-50. It's a four-point game with 2:30 to go. Stevens works against Ethan Christian. And we've got Skittles for David Thibodeau Benoit. He takes the charge. And that's a turnover. Kalen Wolf, that is his fourth. Nope, that is on Shamario Stevens, his fourth. Chicks down by four. Caleb Crowder for the triple from this side, yes. Caleb Crowder makes it a one-point game, 4:53 with 2:12 to go. Going down to the wire in Stillwater. Elimination game. Chieftain spread the floor offensively. Dayton Jackson drives, dumps it off to Cotner, drives in, gets the lay-in, ball game. That's 13 for Will Cotner, his first basket of the second half. Minute 45 left. Possession arrow favors Seminole. Three-pointer for Christian, for Crowder to tie it, can't get it. Will Cotner with the board.
Estimating your project to sale, delivery, and even financing. Plus name brands you've used forever, like Larson Doors, DeWalt Tools, Malarkey Shing.
The Panthers, they win today. They go on to the 2A area consolation semifinals tomorrow. 56-53 here in Stillwater. Chickasha trails Seminole, and Seminole has the basketball. Minute and a half to go. And here is Will Cotner being harassed by Thibodeau Benoit. Now Phelan Wolf to the deep far corner, and the ball comes free. Picked up by Stevens, far sideline, harassed by Brock Henderson. Picks up the dribble now, out to the center circle, and Seminole just played keep away right now. A lot of time left, just a one possession game, but Seminole's been, they are 3 of 5 from the foul line. Driving in, they dump it off of the baseline, and more Skittles for the Chicks. Caleb Crowder gets some Skittles as the offensive foul called on Will Cotner, who just the Chieftains, as he hit three triples to give Seminole the lead in the second quarter. Hit a jumper in the fourth that gave the Chieftains back the lead. But now the Chicks have it, 56-53. Chicks have not had the lead here the entire second half. Henderson and Ethan Christian on the perimeter with Caleb Crowder. Double low post look as Brock Henderson works the baseline. Now he comes out to the near side, drives into the left hand on the baseline to MacGyver Bowles in the left elbow, and Bowles is fouled as he drives. So Seminole's best player with 23 points fouls out with 47 seconds to go. These free throws, Chickasha down by three. Bowles can't get it. Let's see, 5 of 8. 5 of 9 from the foul line today. Gets that one. It's still
can greatly reduce your cost on full medical services, including vision. For more information about this innovative approach to healthcare.
Before, but they trail by two with 48 seconds to go, and Seminole has the ball without their best player. The Chicks go full court man-to-man, and they're going to get a foul here as MacGyver. 40 seconds to go. He's a right-hander. Two quick dribbles, the knee bend, the shot, good. Averaging 6 points, 10 rebounds the ball game. Got his average, and he gets both free throws to the game at 58-54. Henderson lets the ball roll in, picks it up near half court. Almost could have got called for double dribble. Thibodeau Benoit reversing the pass over to Crowder, back to Henderson. To Thibodeau Benoit, around the horn they go. Henderson dribble drive, kicks it out to Crowder for the triple. Yes, a one-point ball game. Caleb Crowder gets his fourth three-pointer of the game. And it's Seminole 58, Chickasha 57 to make a seven-point game a three-point contest. We were relinquished the lead after they took over the game in the second quarter. No lead changes at all after intermission. Our coverage of CHS basketball brought to you by Chickasha Lumber Company. the Oklahoma State University campus, just north of downtown. Chicks go full court man-to-man on the inbounds pass for Seminole. They got to hurry. There's we have a foul on the Chicks on the inbounds pass, double bonus. And Adam Nance hit his last two foul shots and drops that one in, make or miss. Nance gets it done. It's a three-point game with lots of time, 26 seconds. Henderson pushes the ball across the timeline. Dumps it off to Crowder, deep far corner, out to Ethan Christian, 18 seconds to go. Henderson, a long three from 30, off the mark, gets his own rebound and some contact by Dayton Jackson. He's going to be called for the foul, just 4 of 9 today. This is his first free throw try of the fourth quarter. Team foul number 9 on the Chieftains, but this is a two-shot foul for Henderson. And can't get it. But again, have never had the lead after intermission. Coming up after the game, we'll have Dennis Lynam's news. We're running a little bit long on that because of our contest here. And again, congratulations. After the timeout, Henderson back at the line. Second of a two-shot foul. Free throw, no! And Seminole gets the rebound. And they're going to foul Dayton Jackson. His first foul shot in this fourth quarter. And he can, with hitting 1 of 2. And the first is off the heel, won't go. A miss, and then they've got to maybe come down and shoot the three to try to send this game into overtime. But you got to get the miss, and he does miss. Rebound by Ethan Christian to Brock Henderson across the timeline with 8 seconds to go. Between the rings, and a quick timeout for Coach Pulliam with afternoon. Brock Henderson with 20, and for Seminole, Shamario Stevens with 23 points to lead all scorers, but he fouled out with 47 seconds to go. Will Cotner had 13. He fouled out with a minute to go. But Seminole has hit their foul shots in the fourth quarter, 7 of 10, and the Chicks only 1 of 6 from the foul line in this fourth quarter, and 11 of 27 for the game. 5.6 seconds. So Coach Pulliam drawing up the play here on the sideline to the left of our broadcast area. Logan Johnson inbound to the left of our broadcast area. Looks to his left. Looks out near half court to Brock Henderson. 5 seconds, top of the key. Step back three for the tie. Wide left, and the ball goes. And a miracle if they hope to go on. Phelan Wolf to inbound behind the right low blocks. Looks long. Gets heaved near half court. Stolen by Caleb Cutter. A heave from half court the other way is wide right. And Seminole wins it 60 to 57. 60 to 57 is your final, and the Fighting Chick season comes to an end in the Class 4A area tournament as the unranked Chieftains pull the upset against number 11 Chickasha here at Stillwater High School this afternoon. We'll be back with a recap in a moment. This is high school basketball on 106.1 The Ring.